It's the Shambi. Chris, one guy having a big year for this club, leading the team in home runs and runs batted in, Spencer Steer.
Yeah, Boog, he's one of the pillars of this lineup. And when you have a guy like that that's so consistent and so productive, you want to make sure you can do whatever you can to get him to the plate. Get him as many at-bats as you can in a ball game. If you do that, you got a really good chance of scoring a lot of runs.
Well, I'm interested to see how he deals with right-handed hitters in this one. Righties are batting over 300 against him, so they're not being fooled by really anything. He's going to have to find a way to change up his delivery, change up his look, somehow get them off of his primary pitches and even those secondary pitches. So we'll see how he does it in this one.
Could be extra bases. Now he'll turn for second.
Showed some really nice patience in that at bat. Worked himself into a good count. A lot of hitters tell themselves, line drive over the infielder's head. That's what I'm trying to do. Just keep that approach simple. And right there, it was perfectly executed. On time with everything and pulled it into the gap nicely.
And up next for St. Louis, Brendan Donovan. Man at second. That one fouled off, 2-2.
After the loss yesterday afternoon where they really didn't ever get things going on offense, I think this is an important opportunity right here to pick up an early run.
Towards first, and it finds its way through for a hit. Here's the throw to the plate, but it's offline, and it's 1-0.
Well, they strike first as he gets the job done to bring home the run. Didn't try to do too much with it, just a really controlled, simple swing. We don't see a whole lot of that these days with guys trying to launch and hit home runs, but sometimes you got to shorten up just like that.
And up to hit is Wilson Contreras. Liner, base hit. Throw back in quickly. First and second now with nobody out.
He's been swinging it really well lately. I could watch base hits like that one all day long, and so could every hitting coach in the league. Just a nice line drive into center field.
Here's Nolan Gorman. The 1-1. And a foul ball.
It's great to get on the board in the first frame of the ball game, but here's an opportunity for them to really open things up with a couple of runners on. Let's see if they can cash in.
Chase the fastball up the ladder for strike three.
Typically that high fastball, if it's close to the top of the strike zone, a hitter, if he's prepared for it, can get to it. But that one just had that little jump at the end, which indicates there's a good spin rate on it, and it didn't decrease in velocity as that hitter's internal clock would expect it to, and that's why you see the swing and miss.
Here's Nolan Arenado.
Well, with this many pitches thrown here in this first inning, I mean, you're giving the other team a really good look. He's going to have to find a way to get some weak contact.
India, feed to second, that's one. On the four, double play. But the RBI single pushes across a run. And the home team down a run. Major League Baseball is on the show. And we're back. And on the hill in this one, John King.
Yeah, I want to see how he handles left-handed hitters in this lineup today, because coming in, lefties are batting over 300 on the year against him. So he's going to have to figure something out to get inside, keep them from getting their arms extended, and then once conscious of the inside pitch, be able to go with something away and finish them off.
Bottom of the first. In now for the Reds, T.J. Friedl. Smoked in the left, base hit. So a runner aboard to start the inning. Jonathan India to play. The 1-1 is fouled off. And here it comes. And a swing and a miss. And one away.
He's locked in at the plate when he's using the whole field. He was out in front there. Just needs to let the ball travel a little more, and his timing will be back on track. Good pitch for the strikeout.
Spencer Steer, the next to hit for the Reds. And a 1-1. Lined, and that's a base hit. Friedl, round second on his way to third. And they'll have runners at the corners after a one-out single.
just a really nice approach to shoot that line drive to the opposite field. There's a lot of hard work and discipline that goes into getting a result like that at the plate. Doesn't come naturally for most hitters.
Next to hit, Ellie De La Cruz. Swing and a miss. That is strike two.
Well, all eyes on the double play ball in this spot. No better way to get out of this inning.
Lefty out of the stretch. Runners at first and third. Foul ball, another 2-2 upcoming. On the ground. Down the line, and it's foul.
I think ultimately you want to tie him up. Get the ball in on the plate so that he can't get the barrel to it and hit it to the outfield.
Spoils that one, and it remains 2-2.
He's gone off speed. He needs to elevate here with two strikes out of the zone.
Kicks and fires. Gets a piece and stays alive. Ninth pitch of the at-bat due next. And a swing and a miss. Huge strikeout there.
Well, this is where the team aspect really comes into play on the offensive side of the game, right? I mean, missed opportunity to tie it up with the runner at third, one out, couldn't put the ball in play. So now it's time to pick him up. And that's where good teams, they go to. They operate on this level of next man up. That mentality is what causes them to win series, get into the postseason. That helps keep the energy and morale high in the dugout.
And now, Stuart Fairchild. And 1-2. Two on, two outs. That's to third, Arenado. They take the force out. Play made, that ends the inning. Red strand a couple, still behind by a count of 1-0. Back here at Great American Ballpark, second inning set to go. And now the right fielder, Alec Burleson. Next offering down low and in the dirt. That one missed.
Well, he's so great about hitting the ball the other way. He gets those arms extended. So right there, just trying to straighten him up a little bit so he doesn't have as much outside plate coverage.
3-1 now. High in the air, out to right. Martini sizes this one up. Nabs it, one away. Lars Nootbaar next up for the Cardinals.
Here's a batter who, for whatever reasons, plays better on the road, and that should help him here today.
High fly ball lifted in the air right field. Martini snags it for the second out. Jordan Walker will hit next. And he deals. On the corner for a strike. 1-2. That one just misses.
Hey, doubled up on the off speed there. We talk about the power fastball, but he's working a little differently here.
And that skips in the dirt. And down on strikes. It is a three up, three down inning. Nothing doing there for St. Louis, but they still. Ready to go for the last half of the inning. Now batting Jamer Candelario. And there's a ball. Fouls one off. 2-2. kicks and deals. And another ball.
Down at full.
Ground ball, Goldie. He takes it on his own. One up, one down. So digging in, Tyler Stevenson. Fly ball down the line. Burleson hauls it in, two away. Next for Cincinnati, Nick Martini. The Reds down by a run here in game one of this three-game set. That's down and in.
It's a good take.
And a pitch.
Counts full.
Good job to fight that one off. Two down, nobody on. Ground ball, left side. Gathers and throws to first. And that is the third out of the inning. Offense held in check there. We played two full. It's the Cardinals one and the Reds nothing. All set for the start of the inning. Now it's Goldschmidt up to the plate. Right-hander kicks, deals. That one ripped. That ball's carrying. Off the batter's eye and gone. He circles the bases, his seventh home run of the season, and they add a run. It's 2-0.
His confidence is through the roof with the way he's been swinging it lately. He's on a really good run. There he got a splitter that he was able to handle, allowed that pitch to travel a little bit deeper, and when it was time to commit, his hands exploded through the zone.
Mason Winn next up for the Cardinals. On a line, base hit.
Multi-hit game for him now, and with the lack of results he's been having lately, I'm sure he's feeling some relief. Just a solid swing right there. Caught it out front and ripped it into the outfield for the base hit. Those always feel great. And now they've got some speed on first. So.
Runner takes off. That one fouled off. Comes the 2-2. And it goes just foul. Though Chris, through the early stages, he hasn't been very efficient in terms of the pitch count. He's going to need to get some quick outs if he's going to get deeper into this game. Hits and misses. It's a strikeout. Wilson Contreras now up to the plate. This is a guy who is very highly regarded defensively. Fun to watch him control stuff behind the plate. Good game caller, good at framing, but it's that big arm that really stands out. He's got it.
Not fooled at all right there. He was clearly all over it, but sometimes you hit it too hard and right at someone. You're looking for one of those bloop hits to get a knock sometimes.
Here's the second baseman, Nolan Gorman. It is interesting, though, when you consider the way the game is run now, doesn't even matter that much if your starter doesn't go that deep because teams are really aggressively building their bullpens. And that's a base hit. So two on with two away. Here's Nolan Arenado. Swing and a miss as he was late.
Wow, good luck catching up to that one.
Pitch misses, ball two. Two outs. That one not close. Ball three. Alec Burleson in the on-deck circle. Riding to the plate. Fouled off again. And it remains 3-2. Good battle here. About to be the eighth pitch of the at-bat. The other way. And that should be extra bases. One run is in. Around third. He'll score. Two runs are in, and they lead by four.
Just one of those at-bats you almost hate to see come to an end. Nice job of driving that pitch the other way on a line. You know, hitters, they take so many reps in the cages working on going to the opposite field, and it doesn't always translate into the game, but right there it did, and he did it perfectly.
Alec Burleson next up for the Cardinals. Left-hand batter waits.
Love how vocal the umpire is today. No doubt in the hitter's mind, catcher's mind, and even the pitcher's mind as to the conviction in the call.
And another ball. Nato on its second with two down. That's ripped. Base hit. Around third. He will score. And the lead is up to five.
Well, that was one of those high percentage advantage counts where batting averages are just so much higher. That pretty much split the zone down the middle, and those are the ones where you've got to make them pay.
Now up for St. Louis, Lars Nootbaar. Next pitch is outside.
Well, a really rough inning out there on the mound. And this is one of those where you learn a lot about a guy's toughness and his ability to turn the page and keep pressing forward.
Four runs already in the frame. We're here in the top half of inning number three. That one misses, and now 3-1.
Clearly, he hasn't had it in this game, and looks like sooner than later, they're going to have to go to the bullpen.
There at the knees, moving in the bullpen. Ian Jabot getting ready to go. Sims warming up as well. Three balls, two strikes, the count. Swings, threw it, and that's a strikeout. So it's four runs, five hits, no errors, and one left. We head now to the home half of inning number three. It's the Cardinals 5 and the Reds nothing. Set for the bottom of the third and ready to hit now for Cincinnati, Mike Ford. The pitch. Base knock, set field. Just kind of sliced that one into center.
He needed that one. It's been a tough stretch at the plate lately. Everything was on time and fluid in that swing. Got a pitch he could get the barrel on and lined it into center for the knock. Those always feel good.
So back to the top of the Reds lineup. TJ Friedl digs in now.
Leadoff man on. It's time to play a little small ball. Get some base runners. Try to dig yourself out of the hole.
The pitch. Check swing. Did he go? Yes, he did.
1-2 is the count.
The pitch. And a foul ball. He stays alive. The pitch. Gets a piece there. We'll do it again. Runner at first with no outs here. Swing and a miss. Struck him out. And one out now.
Definitely made him chase a little bit out of the zone right there. I don't think that's a strike if he takes it. Pretty textbook pitching. Get ahead in the count, get the guy in the box on his heels, and then force him to chase your pitch where he doesn't have much of a chance to do any damage.
And here comes. Foul ball there. Two down. That one out to right. Makes the catch for the out. And there's two down. So up next, Spencer Steer.
This kid picked up in a trade. A lot was offered and given to get him, but he's got a real high ceiling.
Here's a 1-1. And another ball. Ford off of first with two away. Started to go at the 2-1. Appeal down to first. And yes, he did. That's a swing, according to Kenny Jansen. Here comes a pitch. Still 2-2 after the foul ball. And a pitch. Got it. That is the inning. So one left for Cincinnati. It's 5-0. Welcome back. And now on the mound to start the fourth, Ian Jabot.
And with the big deficit on the scoreboard, he almost has to just put that out of his mind. Every outing matters for relievers and their numbers, but I think it's tough to get up for this type of appearance the same way you would for one in a close game.
Now at the plate, Jordan Walker. So a foul ball makes it 1-2. And that's outside. Lifted left center, way back there, and that is gone. He sends it out of here. Third home run of the season, and they add a run. It's 6-0.
That's a swing that'll boost the win probability for sure. A good hitter gets pitch recognition early. He saw exactly where that was going to be. The challenge, not get over anxious and come out of your swing. He stayed on it and got all of it.
And here's Paul Goldschmidt. And the righty deals. So a foul ball makes it 1-2.
You could see he was trying to stay back long enough to handle the off-speed pitch, but just a little tardy on the fastball.
Packs and misses. It's a strikeout.
I got to think that was the plan all the way. He set him up with a high fastball and then bury that curveball down low to get him swinging. Now, especially with how effective pitchers work up in the zone these days, that's a devastating combination.
So the batting order turns over. Mason Wynn next up for the Cardinals. Up the middle, and he'll be safe at first.
Did a nice job getting there. Good throw, but very difficult to get anybody on that one as far as you had to go and throw, you know?
Yeah, no question. So, man aboard, Brendan Donovan, now at the plate. and a pitch. Swing and a foul straight back. Jabot over to first. Nope. Wynn back on a dive. One run across in the frame so far. Top half of inning number four. And a 1-2. The punch out there. That's the second out.
Well, he throws him with a great fastball right on the corner. It's kind of like bowling when you think the ball's going to get into the gutter and somehow just hangs onto that edge and knocks down a pin. Well, he got the outside corner of the plate and got that called third strike.
Man at first and stepping in for the Cardinals, Wilson Contreras. Swings through that one out in front that time.
1-2.
Wynn leads off first with two down to the inning. Another ball. Foul ball, another 2-2 upcoming. Picks over. Wynn dives back in safely. And that's ball three. Eighth pitch of the at bat coming up. Battling here as he fouls it away. At the belt and fires. In the air out towards right center. And that is that. One for the Cardinals on the solo home run. It's now a 6-0 ball game. You're watching Major League Baseball on the show. Back here in Cincinnati, ready to go, bottom four. And the batter will be the shortstop, Ellie De La Cruz. The wind of the pitch. Bounce to third. One up, one down.
Well, he's doing a nice job of keeping the ball out of the air, lets the defense work behind him with another ground ball. Good execution.
Stuart Fairchild to hit for the Reds. One down, base is empty. Swing and a miss. And the count, 1-2. Meanwhile, activity in the bullpen. Lance Lynn getting loose out there. Up the middle. Whips it to first on the run.
He's out of there.
Two up, two down.
Well, I'm impressed with this guy's internal clock. He knew he had plenty of time to take that extra step, secure his grip on the baseball, and make a strong, accurate throw.
So two down now, and here is Jamer Candelario. Two outs, base is empty. That one the other way, and foul ball. Another 1-2. On the ground, right side. Gorman throws on to first. Three up, three down, inning over. Nobody left for Cincinnati, still up against a 6-0 deficit. Ready now for the fifth inning. Now up the Cardinals' number four hitter, Nolan Gorman. And another ball.
You know, these Cards really impressing me with the quality of their bats in this one. It's been fun getting a chance to see them go to work. It looked to me like they wanted to get to the starter early, get him out of the...
And there's a rocket into the outfield. Makes the turn and heads for second. The throw in. Not in time. He's got a double.
Man, he just absolutely turned on that one. Ripped it down the line. Nice job of staying in his mechanics.
So, man aboard, Nolan Arenado. Next up for the Cardinals. Ball and a strike. Bounced up the middle. Sends it to Ford. One away here in the fifth. Alec Burleson. Next up for the Cardinals.
Fly ball to the outfield for a sac fly. Soft ground ball to the right side. Find a hole. He can attack this a few ways, but the one thing he can't do is strike out.
The 1-2. Now fly ball to right center. Friedel sizing this one up. Drops into the glove. Runner tags for home. The throw's offline. He's saved. And they're pulling away up by seven now.
In that situation, you're looking to get something up in the zone that you can put in the air. Worst case scenario, a sacrifice fly to drive in that runner from third.
And up next for St. Louis, Lars Nootbaar. And that's in for a strike.
He didn't want to give up that run, but he did. Got the fly ball, sac fly out. Now it's time to attack these other guys. Get your team back in the dugout.
Spoils that one, and it remains 2-2. The Cardinals up big in this one, and we're at the top of the fifth. This one trailed to left. No doubt about it as they add on more. Gone. He made him pay for that one. It's 8-0.
That's the exact definition of hitting the ball where it's pitched, taking that outside fastball and driving it the opposite way out of the ballpark. You want to bottle that type of approach.
They go with one of their more experienced arms in this spot, Buck Farmer.
I think it's got to be a little tough coming in out of the pen when your guys are trailing so big on the scoreboard. Just doesn't have the same intensity to it, but he's got to find a way because these batters count the same for his stats, obviously, regardless of the score.
So two away with nobody on. Here's the center fielder, Jordan Walker. Plenty of offense in this one, Singy. I guess you'd say kind of what we expected, though.
Well, this was a game, looking at the pitching matchup, where you expected offense to score, and not as lopsided as this. But yeah, you definitely expected to see some offense coming up.
Tosses to first, and that is the inning. So they get two runs on two hits. One of them left the yard. Home half of the fifth coming up. It's the Cardinals 8 and the Reds nothing. Back now to start the bottom of the fifth and taking over on the mound, Lance Lynn.
Well, they didn't get much length out of their starter in this one, so they've got a lot of outs to eat up in that bullpen. I think they'll look for some length out of him right here if they can get it.
And now it's going to be Tyler Stevenson.
Well, every pitcher wants run support, and having a lead is nice, but it can be challenging for some pitchers. I think keeping the mindset to attack instead of trying to be too fine and have too much finesse, go after hitters and get quick outs.
Goldie calls it in, and there's one away. Nick Martini, the next to hit for the Reds. One down, base is empty. Falling That's behind, 2-1. Wouldn't ball. Chase that time.
3-1.
Hawaii to kick the pitch. And there's a foul ball. Swings through that one. It's a strikeout.
You know, variant speeds can be just as useful for a pitcher as movement. As you see right there, it really wasn't a great location. But the fact that the velocity change had the hitter off balance, and that's all you got to do sometimes.
And a pitch. So a foul ball makes it 1-2. Two down, nobody on. There's a swing and a drive. That's back there. And out of here. It's his sixth home run of the season. It's 8-1.
Home runs where you really don't know if he got enough of it off the bat. I mean, he put a swing on it clearly, but I wouldn't say he really got the sweet spot on the bat. The exit velo wasn't anything too impressive, but it had all it needed for him to circle the pillows.
Next to hit, TJ Friedl. That's a strike across the top of the zone. And now the count is full, and another power hitter lurking in the on-deck circle. That's the third. Over to Goldie. Inning over. One for the Reds on the homer. It's now 8-1. It's Major League Baseball, and it's on the show. Top of the sixth inning. Now up for St. Louis, Paul Goldschmidt. Just missed. Double-barreled action in the bullpen. Brent Suter loosening up for manager David Bell. Sims, a right-hander, loosening up as well. The wind and the pitch. And another ball.
First pitch strike from the pitcher, but then no panic at all by the hitter. Very patient, showing good discipline. Now he's in the driver's seat with a 3-1 count.
There's a strike.
Well, that's really the money spot. Down and away, if you can locate that consistently, it's going to be real tough for hitters to square that off. That's what you love to see relievers do coming out of that bullpen.
Out there to center. Friedl makes the grab, one down. Now it's the shortstop, Mason Wynn.
No matter what, you're playing this kind of rival to take your game to another level.
One down, base is empty. Hard hit, right side. India over to first in time. Got the out. Next is the designated hitter, Brendan Donovan. The Redbirds up big in this one, and we're at the top half of the sixth. Swing and a miss, and he is down on strikes for the third straight at bat. No runs, no hits, no errors. 2-3-4 due up in the home half of the sixth. It's the Cardinals 8 and the Reds 1. Bottom of the sixth inning. In now for the Reds, Jonathan India. One one now. On the inside corner for a strike. Fouls that off to the left and will do it again. The wind of the pitch. Fights that one away. Still one and two. Righty delivers. Sets him down looking. He's got to be frustrated with that call.
Well, definitely a borderline pitch right there. And he didn't look too convinced as he headed back to the dugout. You know, those are tough ones to let go as a hitter, but with the human umpire calling balls and strikes, it's always going to be on you to protect yourself with two strikes.
Next for Cincinnati, Spencer Steer. Outside low, and a count 2-1. The Reds with a lot of ground to make up here in the bottom of the sixth. Kicks and fires. Not even close there. 3-2 down. Keeps the at bat going with a foul ball. And he deals. Here's a swing drive left field, and he knew it. Them all. His 11th of the year, it's 8-2. He kept swinging and it paid off.
Well, that was a battle, Boog, and he just kept taking his cuts and finally squared one up. Looks like this guy was looking out over the plate, but he was ready to turn on the inside fastball. So direct to the pitch, absolutely blasted out of this ballpark.
Ellie De La Cruz, the next to hit for the Reds. The pitch. So, a foul ball makes it 1-2. Right-handed reliever. Knocks that one away, and we'll do it again. The shortstop takes a ball.
Flew open a little bit with that front shoulder, but was able to slow his back down just enough to make contact with that pitch. Keep the at-bat alive.
That one missing inside. In the air, left field. Nootbaar calls it in, and there's two away. Two outs, bases empty. Stuart Fairchild, the next to hit for the Reds. Two down, nobody on. Here in game one of this three-game set. And down on strikes he goes. That ends the inning. But a solo home run will at least get this closer to respectability. And this is now an 8-2 ball game. Back after this on the show. And we're back. We go to the top of the seventh. And now the Cardinals catcher, Wilson Contreras. Flips the corner.
Two and two.
What a stop! Throws from his knees. Nicely done for the out.
Well, he makes a great decision to go ahead and dive to stop that ball. Nice little flip to the pitcher covering.
Those are those PFPs, pitchers fielding plays.
So here's the cleanup hitter, Nolan Gorman. One down, base is empty. And that one is in the dirt. The count now 2-2. He goes down looking.
Really love the pitch sequence right there. I'm telling you what, pitcher and catcher on the same page right now.
Two outs, base is empty. Here's the third baseman, Nolan Arenado. Swing and a miss, and he was fooled.
Got two outs and a chance to put up a zero on the scoreboard here, and that's not something that's come easy for this staff in this one.
Here's a 1-2. And that's outside.
That's the ball.
Really nice slider right there. Sweeping across the dish, but just couldn't hang the edge.
Line drive. Makes the catch. And that is that. Redbirds down quietly. They lead it 8-2. We're back in a new pitcher here to start the bottom of the seventh. Zach Thompson.
And as relievers go, he's not a big strikeout guy. He tries to force weak contact, so command and execution are huge for him.
Jamer Candelario getting ready to hit. Kicks and deals. Got the bat going too soon. It's strike two. Action in the pen down there. Andrew Kittredge, the right-handed sinker baller. He looks to be readying himself. The pitch stays alive. And now the lefty, still 2-2 after the foul ball. Spoils the two-strike pitch, and he'll see another. At the belt and fires. That's foul to the right side. Keeps the AB going. Here's a 2-2. To the right side. Gorman throws it to first. That was a strong at bat, even though he couldn't find a way on base.
Well, he didn't recognize changeup earlier enough. Got out in front a little bit, rolled over on it, and beat it into the ground.
And here's the catcher, Tyler Stevenson. Base is empty, one away. Here, the bottom of the seventh. Wouldn't ball. Chase that time.
I can't play around with him here. It's a six-run lead at this point. Got to attack hitters, even if you give up a solo shot.
Ball. Pitch misses there, and that's ball three. And here it comes. He swings and fouls one off. Foul ball, and it remains a full count. Payoff pitch. Chop back up the middle. Throws to first in time. Two up, two down. Nick Martini, the next to hit. And the pitch. Foul ball. And a swing and a miss. And a nice inning of work there as he sets him down 1-2-3. Reds go down quietly. And it's still 8-2. Welcome back, and a new arm on the mound to start the eighth. Brent Suter.
He's averaging more than one hit allowed per inning pitch this season, and that's not where you want to be at all. So we'll see how he does here.
So digging in, Alec Burleson. And that gets the top of the zone for a strike. Left-hand batter waits. Fouls it off, still 1-2. Next offering is outside. Swings and misses. He didn't make it easy for him on the mound, but they still get the strikeout. Lars Nootbaar next up for the Cardinals. The pitch. That one misses. Three balls and a strike. Three, one, and he couldn't come up with it.
His ability to draw walks has been something that's been part of his career since day one.
Man at first with one gone. Now here is Jordan Walker. Nootbaar over at first with one away. Swings through that one above the zone.
I don't think anyone's got good numbers swinging at pitches in that location.
And a ball evens the count.
Recognize that changeup right out of the hand. Just spit on it.
And another ball.
Full count.
And a pitch. Fouled off again. And it remains 3-2. Here comes a pitch. And ball four to a board. Two on with one out. And now the first baseman, Paul Goldschmidt. The Cards up big in this one. And we're in the top of the eighth. And that's just foul. And a pitch. Swing and a miss. Struck him out. Back to the top of the lineup. Now a chance for Mason Wynn. Two on, two outs. In the air, left field. And that is a foul ball. Swing and a miss. That one in the dirt. Stevenson to first. In time, the 2-3 strikeout ends the inning. Welcome back to the ballpark. Out of the bottom of the eighth, Mike Ford at the plate. And a foul ball. Left-hand hitter waits. And a foul ball. He stays alive. Here's a 2-2. And another ball. Clobber to right field. Way back. Gone. his second home run of the game, and they cut into the deficit. It's 8-3.
Knew what pitch he wanted to hit, spit on some other pitches in this at bat, was very patient, and it paid off.
A new arm into the game, the righty, Giovanni Gallegos.
And he's got a nice lead to work with, so he should come in throwing strikes, attacking these hitters.
Now here's the Reds leadoff man, TJ Friedl. The pitch. That's inside. The 2-1. Foul back our way, and that's out of play. And he can't come up with it. To first, and he just gets it there in time. One away. And ready to hit now for Cincinnati, Jonathan India. One out, bases empty, and a run in here in the bottom half of the eighth inning. And he chases a high fastball there. Action in the St. Louis bullpen. Number 64 preparing to come on if needed. Kittredge also throwing. The 1-2. Yeah, that's too high. That one misses. Full count now.
Full count.
And the righty deals. In the air, right field. Coming on. Brings it in. Two away now. Two outs, base is empty. Now the batter now, Spencer Steer. Two outs. So a foul ball makes it 1-2. The right-hander deals. Got it by him for the K. One scores in the inning coming on this solo home run. It's now 8-3. You're dialed into the show. We're back. It's the top of the ninth, and there's a new pitcher on the mound, Emilio Pagan.
Well, they need someone to stop the bleeding and keep the score right where it is. Seems like a tough task today with the way this lineup is swinging it.
Here's a 1-1. And it's fouled away. The pitch. And
that's
another ball.
Boog, he never moved because he never had time to. But that kind of velocity, you'd prefer that pitcher work away.
That one misses in the dirt. And it finds its way through for a hit. And the leadoff man aboard.
He was all over that one. Just a simple ground ball the other way that had eyes on it, man. Sometimes that's all you need to do. Just let the ball travel, put the ball in play, and just hope it finds a hole.
Wilson Contreras digs in now. Here's a 1-1. And that one fouled off. Righty delivers. Swings and misses. Struck him out.
Boog, if you can set up a good two-strike splitter with the fastball on the previous pitch, it's going to be so tough to recognize and adjust your swing to get a piece of it. Clearly had him reaching for it right there.
Man at first. Now, Nolan Gorman. Kicks and fires.
Ball.
That one called just inside, I think, and on the mound. He's trying to get a little bit of an explanation. Doesn't seem to be too bothered by it, though, but he clearly thought it clipped the corner.
And a 2-1 on the way. And a foul ball. Donovan at first, one gone. Righty to the plate. Yeah, that's outside. 3-2 now.
And that's awfully close. I don't know how you take that. He's seeing the ball out of the pitcher's hand really well right now.
Foul. We'll see another payoff pitch. High fly ball, pretty well struck out to right center. Martini going back, and it's off the wall. Donovan around second, headed for third. Lead runner holds at third, so two runners in scoring position and just one out.
Everything came together for him. He tried to jam him inside with the cutter, and he got it in there, but I have a feeling he was sitting on that pitch, that location, because he was all over.
Nolan Arenado now at the plate. And he deals. That one catches the zone. That's strike two. And a pitch. That one ripped left field. And it's gone. Home run number 5 on the season. It's 11-3. That's their fourth home run of the game.
They can't stop, and they won't stop hitting home runs in this one, Boog. They're clearly feeding off of each other at the dish. That's exactly the pitch he was looking for. Crushes it and hits it out of the ballpark.
New pitcher for the Reds, Sam Moll. One out, base is empty. And stepping in for the Cardinals, Alec Burleson. And now the lefty comes up empty. That's strike two.
1-2 is the count.
One out, base is empty. Pitch. That one the other way, and it's caught for the out.
It's never fun going back to the dugout after hitting a line drive that finds a glove, but you will get some high fives. You know, when you make great contact, you feel like you've done everything right. But in this game of baseball, not everything is in your control.
Two down, nobody on. Fall off foul. And a 1-2. Fouls it back with two strikes. And ball. Another ball.
2-2.
got him swinging. But the biggest swing of the inning comes right here, a three-run homer. On now to the bottom of inning number 9. You're watching Major League Baseball exclusively on the show. Last chance for the home team. And now, Ellie De La Cruz. That one is absolutely belted. Newt ball, drop step, going back. Got it! Great leaping catch!
What an outstanding effort going all the way back to the warning track and leaving his feet to bring that one in. It's so tough to jump on the run like that and time it perfectly, so that was awesome.
He's two outs away. Now it's the DH, Stuart Fairchild. And that's another ball.
3-1.
Base is empty, one away here in the last half of inning number 9. Swing and a pop up. And he makes the catch. Out number 2. So they're down to their final out. And now it's switch hitting third baseman Jamer Candelario. And there's the strike. This could end it. Swing and a miss, and he got him. And that'll do it.
Well, a big win by 8 runs. And when you have that kind of lead, do you make it easier for the pitching staff to come out, make their pitches, pitch to contact, and not worry about giving up the lead? So nice job today all the way around to get the W.
And your final, 11-3. For Chris Singleton and our entire outstanding crew here at MLB The Show, I'm John Shombe. We'll see you soon.